Year 1897, J.J. Thompson, this J.J. Thompson did some experiments on a electrical discharge. Here, in this electrical discharge, based on this electrical discharge, he found that there is a nucleus and which has the positive charges, negative charges. Because of these negative charges in the electric discharge, he can get some scintillations or the flashes in the discharge tube. Here, that means based on this scintillations, he found that some negatively charged charges are present in an element. And not only this negatively charged particles, and also some of the positively charged particles also present, because this negatively charged particles and because of the positively charged particles present in an atom, then they are electrically neutrified. That's why he got that because of negatively charged particles and positively charged particles are also present in an atom. Then here how these negatively charged particles and how these positively charged particles are arranged in an atom. That is how what is the structure of an atom. This structure of an atom is given by J.J. Thompson, that is called a plum pudding model. Here, this plum pudding model, based on this plum pudding model, the negatively charged ions, that means this positively charged ions are distributed among the volume of an element. Here, the positively charged ions are distributed among the volume of the atom, and the negatively charged ions are as like seeds in a watermelon, because this is like a plum pudding model, and this plum pudding model or the structure of an atom is given by the J.J. Thompson. And after this J.J. Thompson, there are some other atomic models are there. Now, in this lesson, we'll study about the structure of an atom, what we have today. Now, here, this atom consists positively charged ions and negatively charged particles. And these particles, this negatively charged particles are revolving around the revolving, and this gives the radiation. Because of this radiations are the, that is electromagnetic radiations, then there will be, we get spectrum, we'll get the spectrum. And each element or each atom has a characteristic spectrum. Each atom has a characteristic different spectrum for each element, and this spectrum in this this about the spectrum we will study in this lesson. Right here, after this in the year 1885, Johann Balmer, here he is the Swedish teacher, he conducted some experiments, and he got the spectral series. He got some spectral series which has a regular pattern for the hydrogen atom, and by using some empirical formula he got a spectral lines, and that is the Balmer series he got. And after that, In the year 1906, here Rutherford, Ernest Rutherford did some experiments, and he conducted an experiment on the alpha particle, alpha scattering experiment. And in the year 1911, this Ernest Rutherford experiment that is conducted and performed by the Giger scientist and Ernest. Okay, these scientists conducted and performed this alpha scattering experiment, and this Rutherford given the nuclear atomic model, that is as a planetary atomic model. Planetary atomic model. According to this Rutherford, the electrons revolve around the nucleus, and that means the positively charged particles are in the nucleus and electrons are revolving around the nucleus as like planets revolving around the sun. This is called a planetary atomic model or a nuclear atomic model. Nuclear atomic model. This is about the atoms present, that is a structure of atom, that means atom, how we got this structure of atom. Here now alpha particles, that is a alpha scattering experiment. Now alpha scattering experiment, here in the alpha scattering experiment, this conducted by alpha particle scattering experiment. This alpha particle scattering experiment is given by Rutherford and conducted by the Giger and other scientists. And here, according to this alpha scattering experiment, he got